and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a new art tutorial for you, obviously. And it's another mid-nail art. It's about a leprechaun king who wanted to get a bride, but stuff just didn't really work out in his favor. Also, just with the whole theme of the background and all, I felt like it was a nice one to do at the end of summer with the bright colors. As usual, I'm starting out with a buffed acrylic nail. I have gel polish on there, it doesn't matter really. Just as long as you start with a matte nail. On a natural nail, you could of course always start with a matte nail polish. Because the matte effect is just going to make sure that the acrylic paints are going to grab on better. And other than that, and acrylic paints, like I said, and the base, I'm also using regular nail art brushes, which I got off eBay at some point in time. But yeah, as long as the background is still wet, I'm still going to stipple on white to create clouds. Just a very easy way to do so, because you're supposed to be slightly see-through, because there are clouds and all. And then I'm going to start on the mountain. Basically, the story is about a leprechaun king, like I said, who lived in a kingdom, presumably far, far away or something like that. In a mountain, and always the outside of the mountain was covered in beautiful flowers, and everyone in the kingdom was very happy, including the king, but he wasn't completely happy because he didn't want a wife, but he needed a princess for that, because, you know, in those days a king just couldn't marry anyone but a princess, apparently. And yeah, so he went in search of one as a dandelion fluff thingy. I feel like they should have a regular name, like, yeah. But like one of those little thingies that comes from a dandelion. Which I feel like I'm pronouncing wrong. Point being, he went in search of a wife and he found a human princess who he really liked. But obviously she wasn't all too keen on, you know, going with him and living inside a mountain with a leprechaun kingdom. I mean, quite frankly, I wouldn't want to live in a mountain either. So I can sort of understand her reluctance to go with him. So he bewitched her and then took her along against her will. Eventually she was saved and he was pissed off. And then the mountain never grew flowers again, and he just kept all the beauty of his kingdom inside the mountain and didn't come out anymore to the human world. Interestingly enough, the book I read, a lot of books really that tell that story, it's quite a well-known myth really, tell it as if it was some kind of, you know, wrongful deeds towards the leprechaun king for not allowing him his bride. Which I always thought sort of odd, because technically he did in fact actually, you know, abduct her against her will. Which, you know, isn't really a good thing. Anyhow, back to the actual painting. I'm doing the outlines in white, as you can see. I feel black would have been a bit too stark, and also I figured with the white at the edges, it seems like the sun is behind the mountain and just lighting up the outside of it. And I'm also putting some more detail in there just to make it seem as if there's literally like all kinds of tiny flower fields on the mountain. It just makes the entire thing look a little bit more detailed. Basically, I'm just drawing random shapes on it. But yeah, I do feel like it really makes a difference in how intricate the entire thing looks. And of course, if you want to do different colored flowers, you know, like, really all the stories only say flowers, they don't specifically mention the type or color of flowers, just that it was very colorful. So yeah, if you want to do a nail art like this as well, you can really go with any color scheme you like. Anyway, then it's time to let it dry fully, the acrylic paint I mean, and then it's time for top coat. I'm using a gel top coat that dries matte. You could of course also use a normal top coat, doesn't matter, whatever you prefer. And then we're done. So yeah, this is the final result. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more videos of me, mainly makeup tutorials, like lots of makeup tutorials, you can always subscribe to my channel. Oh, that was my laptop telling me that the battery is nearly dying. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!